My name is Evgeny Ivanov. I'm a third-year PhD student of the University of Liège, and I'm going to present the results of how the offshore wind farms and the dredging activities affect the sediment transport. So the object of the study is the Belgian coastal zone is highly affected by the human activities, but in this study I'm going to focus on two of them, the aggregate extraction and subsequent dumping, and the operation of wind farms. So for this study, I used the coupled model. It has a core of hydrodynamical model ROMS, coupled with the wave models 1, coupled with the sediment model. So you see around this graph a whole bunch of data which we used, and I have to thank Ulysse to provide the sediment maps for the Belgian coastal zone. So running this model, we get temperature, salinity, currents, waves, suspended particulate matter, and so on, a result for the whole domain. For the high resolution grid on the Belgian coast, covering the Belgian coastal zone, and the coarse resolution grid, which is covered, covering the south and white of the North Sea and the English Channel, into an estimate. The extensive validation was conducted in order to be sure that the model does good. So you see the graph of the amphidromes of the tidal amplitude. You see the suspended particulate matter near Knocke Heist, the mud. So you see the bottom stress map, the salinity plume, the wave heights, and also for temperature, salinity, tidal currents, and so on. So I don't present the validation here because it's a very technical thing, but I have to again thank Ulysse to provide a little bit of validation. So then we were sure that the model is good. They started to do some analysis. So you see here the case study. Here you see the clustering of the weather patterns. So we put temperature and wind in both directions. We learned and the clustering method, supervised learning, classified them into 5 categories. So, and for each of those categories, we had to understand the pattern, how we will affect the water environment and subsequently the sediments. And they do affect. So you see the difference in, for example, in the spring and summer and a different way, direction of wind, how the salinity plume from scale behaves. So it's quite different. But the biggest difference between spring and neap tide, spring tide, just to remind you, it's twice bigger than the neap tide by the amplitude. So here we test two scenarios. The first scenario is a wind turbine, which is operating. So it stresses the sediments, and the sediments go up and being removed with the tidal current. So the concentration of the sediments near the bottom is 15 milligram per liter during the spring tide, which is 5 times bigger than the ground concentration of 3 milligram per liter. So, and we put the one wind turbine at the Bell Wind. And we also dumped 20,000 tons of the scaled mud into the dumping place B1. So those are two scenarios. So first dumping. So you see here the map of dumping during spring tide and the neap tide. But basically tides are not that important at the tidal phase itself. So this is the map after one day of from dumping. And on the left hand side you see the tidal phase, and the current goes to this direction, and it moves the dumping mud into inside of the Belgian coastal zone. And on the right hand side you see that actually current goes in another direction since it's a high tide, and it moves to the Dutch, the mud. And here you see the animation of the turbid wake during the spring tide and during the neap tide. So on the left hand side you see how the amplitude is going, the amplitude of the water level. So, and due to there's a spring tide, the currents are also huge, they move sediments, and the sediment wake goes 2 kilometers far, back and forth, back and forth. On the right hand side you barely see anything. You will see some a bit of the plume, but there's not that big and important. And basically this is actually the truth. So I will show you the picture, and the picture is a satellite picture, and you see all those bunch of white dots. So these are individual wind farm, individual wind turbines, and you see the tails. So the tails are the sediments, and if you put the scale on the left corner, so you will see that actually this is exactly 2 kilometers far. So I have to thank VESPO for sponsoring the project, FACIT project. Thank for my colleagues, thank Liz for providing all this data, and thank for your attention.